Sybase Azure and IBM DB2 LUW, this version. We can find this information on the website. I can show you after where to find the information by yourself. DB Optimizer, the last part, the last product of the bundle of DB Power Studio, is the solution to optimize and to profile your databases. You can easily connect to your database and start a profiling session to see what is happening currently in your database, and other features to automatically generate the different query plans to execute the query and automatically find the better query plan to use to have the better performance with his queries. Okay. Let's focus on DB Change Manager now, in the product. For the information on the website, if you go to idera.com, you will see directly from products, you can find DB Power Studio. In DB Power Studio, if you click, you will find the different product I just spoke earlier. And from this product, you can select DB Change Manager. And from here, you can have different information. And the most important part is you have buttons to start for free. You can download the trial version of the product directly on your workstation and install it to test the solution. Everything I will show you today, you can reproduce it on your side and check if it match with the features that you are looking for. So, DB Change Manager is here. I'm just launching it. Behind the scene, I have launched different virtual machines to host my databases. I have some Oracle and MS SQL directly available in this virtual machine, so I will be able to connect to this machine. When you have downloaded a trial version, you should receive a serial number to register, and then when you have installed it, when you launch it, you will have this welcome message, which helps you to easily find all the information I will speak about today. For getting started, I can this wizard ask me if I want to compare from the schema. The object from my schema, I can capture a snapshot from the schema, I can set up my databases, which is the first things to do when you install the product. You need to set up some data sources to be able to connect. I will show you mine on the left part of the product. And if you select for specific things, if I select, for example, schema archive, automatically we'll open this part, and I have my cheat sheets, which is open, which shows directly me all the different information. I can navigate and click the different steps, reproduce, and do it directly. So I know them, I will reduce this part. On the left part, like I said, we have all our data sources. We currently see some folders. In my folders, I have my different data sources. When you first install the product, you will need to register these data sources. So, like I said, we are supporting DB2, SQL Server, Oracle, and Sybase Azure for now. So, from here, we can directly click on the database platform that we want to register. We can select the folder where to register it, a category to have some colors directly on the icon itself to easily see if we are working currently on the database platform, which is for our production environment or if it's a test environment and so on. So easily tag this data source. And from here, as I have selected Microsoft SQL Server, I have specific fields to fill in order to be able to connect to my database. When I have provided all this, I will be able to connect to it. If I edit when I have registered, for example, I have my virtual machine instance name, the port I use, and the user I'm using. Okay. So now I can easily expand this node, and directly I can expand my database objects, and I will be able to see the different databases that are hosted in my server, and I will be able to check directly from here my different objects. I can see this table, I can easily see the columns that I have inside it, I can right click and extract some data to see what's happening, what is contained in my table. So for example, from here, as you can see, we are able also able to create some SQL, not to create, to write some SQL script from here, and I will be able to have some code completion directly here, and I will be able to prefix the cache is not done yet, and should be James. Oh. Yeah, so, it needs to load some cache to be able to provide the colon and so on. So you can use this this wizard to not this wizard this this edit to type all the SQL script you need and directly be able to check the data that you have. So from here I can see my database, my different objects like I show you. And the most important part was are the different wizard to work with. So I have for the configuration, I have two different kind of jobs. I have one to create an archive, which is a snapshot I can generate for all my configuration. I can do the same for the schema. And the other one is comparison. So I will be able for a comparison to compare two different databases or to compare some archives with other archives or with live databases. So we'll start with archive. I can create a new one. I will give a name to my archive. This is config. Yeah, this is perfect. I can put some notes. I can specify a specific project to store my my job and to aggregate all my different task jobs. When I have specified this step, I can click here, for example, to go to refinements. I can also use the tabs that are here. I can use back and next button. So lots of different ways to manipulate it. I haven't chosen my my source because I was under a data source and I have created a new job, a new archive job. You can easily change your job by drag and drop this source and it automatically changes it. From all the refinements, I will be able to see from here all the different values, configuration, properties, parameters that can be extracted from the servers, from the server directly. And then you have the different options. If I want to extract the DDL for the specific options that I can change with DDL, I can specify different options for automatically delete to purge the older version after the value I set here if I want. When I run a job, I will be able to each time to specify if I want to receive an email, if I want to be notified with my with the file directly or with my with an icon in the SysTray by itself here. And the last one is the history. When you have run your job, it has been performed, and this new job, when I save it, I will see my first version, and if I run it again, I save it again, and in my history, I have two new versions, okay, of this same job, okay, and if I check my result, I can see from here directly all the values. I can export it in a specific in a specific format. For example, RTF if I want to use it with Word, PDF if I want to generate a PDF, and so on. If I click browse, I can go to let's select the desktop. I will select SQL Server 20. Okay. Copy the name. CSV no, I said PDF, it will be better. Okay. I can specify all my all the different parameters I want for my report. And when I click the finish button, automatically will generate my my report. It should be finished. If I go to my folder, it was here. Can open it and you see that it has automatically generated a report with all my values. So this is the archive, the configuration archive job, how it works. I can click here and it will generate a report directly from here. I can see it and browse my different pages from there. That's it for the configuration archive job. Quite simple. I can do the same for the comparison job this time. So I will say it is config job one and I will compare for example this SQL server here with another one which is another VM and another version. Let's compare with this one. I'm just keeping the same platform SQL server for my example because for the configuration itself it really doesn't, for me it doesn't make sense to compare the configuration itself. For the schema, yes, but not for for the configuration. We support it, but not very interesting. So I can use, like I said, for the first one, we create some archive of my configuration. So I can use my live source, so connect directly to the databases. Or if I have some, I can connect to an archive and from this archive, the one we have created together is config archive job one, and I can select this job and I can use the latest release we have created, which is version 2, or I can use a previous version or a specific version if I want to compare with V1 and so on. I will be able to select which version I want to compare each time. Okay. So very interesting to create some archive to be able to reuse them to compare with a specific version you have of your environment. So I'm using most recent with another database. If I go to the refinements, I can select the properties I want and so on. Automatically, it takes the properties from the first, from this source I have selected here. Different options, notification, history, I can click the play button. And we can see here that we have 84%, which are the same, and some differences between the two. 9 properties not found. As like I said, we are not using the same version of SQL Server, so makes sense that some configuration parameters has been deprecated, the name has changed, or stuff like this. Sense and some others didn't match the value are not the same, so I can easily click what I want to show generate SQL script no, but I want to view report like previous time. I can easily see the differences and browse my pages to see what are my values. This one here. I can see this properties doesn't exist anymore. And I can see here, okay, the product version is different. The memory size of my virtual machine are different. File versions, the same. Windows version are different and so on. Okay. So I can easily create this query. The differences only concern the version of the of the database and Windows. I can click the generate script, but I don't have any properties which are that I can change with SQL. I can run whatever the query I can run. It will not change my Windows version and stuff like that. Okay. So that's it for the configuration. We can go to the next part, which is schema and archive archive and schema comparison jobs. So I can do the same as we have done for the configuration. Can click and create a new configuration job. We'll call it schema archive job one. I'm using this data source. From the refinement part, we'll have more data than for the configuration, for the schema. I can select the schema I am interested by. The two parts on the left, this one and this one, are only filters, and what we will collect from the database is the right part. Okay. So from here, I'm just filtering some data. I'm just interested by my table and dependencies. I don't want the server type and so on. And from here, I don't want the schema. And if I check, I can see the table we have shown earlier when I expand this node. It's okay for me. In the option, we can select if you want to include the dependencies from the table directly in my archive. If I want to extract the DDL, I can use, can extract my DDL. The same option to purge, to remove the old versions, notifications, and option, next. And I can click the play button to automatically extract all my objects from my game schema. And if I want to see my scheme database, I have MS SQL for now, and I can easily see what I have extracted from my archive. Okay, so like I said, for the configuration, you can create with this archive job easily some version, some specific release to be able to compare later with different other implementation of my database, and to be able to see all the differences between my my version, my release I have created, and the current version, for example, or another version. And from there, with the comparison jobs I will show just after, we will be able to generate some script to synchronize the different schema. So I save my job. I will see in my history my version 1, and I can replay it later and so on. If I go to schema comparison job, I create a new one. Like earlier, I can use my archive, or I can use the two live data source. I will compare with SQL Server with this other one. Okay. Tac, tac, tac. I use rename this. I go to refinement. I will select my game. Server object I'm not interested. I will take only game. So this is why I spoke earlier of, about the trial version. I'm just showing you some a simple database with some example, and I really encourage you to download the product and to test it in your own environment to be able to check it. Select target MS game, it's okay. Tac tac tac. Refresh database, it's okay. And this one is also important. Refinement to select the object. My options to select my my different options. I have two. The first one is doesn't really the first one really change the behavior, because the first is manual, so it will compare but doesn't change anything. But the second one is very dangerous, because you will automatically synchronize your databases. It can be useful in a test environment or specific development environment, when with the automatic feature, we can easily compare two version and automatically when the difference between the database schema is above a threshold that we define, we can specify that it will automatically update the database. So as it is automatic, you know the risk that you can delete some important things and things like this, or you can use a manual one. Depends, really depends. But on production environment, I will not choose the automatic one, for instance. In the other option, we have lots of them, but some are interesting. If it only exists in one of the parts, should we drop this object, or should we just ignore it, and different things like this for my different option. And I can also extract my DDL, for example, to be sure I have a copy at least of my database earlier for later. I click the play button, notification history as usual, and it is automatically connecting. It has automatically connected to my two databases, extracted the different schema, and I see that I have 77% matches. I can generate from here a script, but one error, I can show it, should be primary key index. Yeah, it's normal. I can show my individual result from here. I can easily filter and see my different object, kind of object. On the right part, I can uncheck my match. So I can only see, I will only see the different object. And from here, I can easily click on a table, for example. And I can see from there the difference. I have view details here, which shows me that my last name and first name columns in my first database, it is 60. In the other one, it is 40. 25, 20, okay, directly I can export this result. I can also view the differences as with my 2DDL, I can compare directly my script from here, okay. Navigate in each difference. I can easily see the source DDL and the target DDL. So if I want to compare it manually, I can do it. I can open change script from here, and from this script, like I said earlier, as we have a SQL editor directly in the product, we can play this script, and it will automatically alter my database, if I have the rights, of course, if I have the good credentials to perform the query. And I can click the play button, and we will automatically change my database. We'll save my comparison job, and if I replay it directly as I have gone my alter DDL, now I see I have 83%, so if I check my results from here, I match and change, I see that I have, yes, source only, I haven't compare, this is for the view, this is because sorry. Compare the same thing. Don't match link and client. 60, 20. Ah, broker. Ah, yeah, my bad. I have only generated the script for the table I was on. So I haven't changed it for client. Sorry for the. I had to understand why it didn't work. So as I have done it only for the current object from here, okay. I should have used generate a script which generate the script for all the objects, and from here I can play this script. Okay. And so I can save it once again. So I have two versions. I will create my third one. 84%, which is better. Which is different? Top match. This is my view. They modify. Yeah. Close. Differences. Okay, the syntax is not the same with we. Okay. Probably in the option I can refine and avoid this this false positive. That's it. Just summary, so I can see all the different objects and I can export my my script to save it to my drive. I can generate a report like we see earlier if you want to use it for example with Excel. I will probably choose a CSV. If I want to generate directly a HTML page, I will select this one, PDF, Word, depending on what I want to do with this report. So that's it for the save it. And like I said, if we go back to history, I will see directly from here my different run, and I will be able to select directly the one I want with the individual result and so on. Okay. So this was for the schema. And the last feature is for data itself. For the data, we don't provide an archive job because we are not providing this feature to extract all the data from a database. We are just comparing the data directly from two databases. So, like you see, there's no option for live or archive. I will name it data. Database SQL Server 1. I can compare with SQL Server 2 with this one. Don't know if they have the good release. If I select GIMP in the two, okay, option. For the option, depending on what way you select, like you see, I have drop, recreate, or not, for the key. I have different options for how we will compare the data. And like I said, for the schema, we have an option for automatic synchronization, which means that if you have run your automatic synchronization with the schema, you can run the job to do it for the data itself too. I haven't mentioned it, but each time you can create a job, for each job, you can create a command line to run this job from a batch from your computer or from an ANT script if you use it. So from automatically synchronize with this option, we also provide some feature like data masking to, for example, if you have a credit card number or some information you want to hide when you copy the database from the source to your target. You can specify some data masking to hide or to generate some data similar to the original one, but different to be sure, or to shuffle all the data to be sure that the data can't be used in a bad way. So yes, okay, manually. So I can select different database, map, change my mapping. From here, I will click to inspect my database, my two databases, from my source and my target. And from here, I'm able to see my different table and the different columns that will be used for the comparison directly. And I can also edit the SQL if I want to only have a subset. Stuff like this, I can use this feature to automatically remove some data. Notification, history as usual. Finish. I run the job. It is running. Yeah. Okay. Everything is running on my laptop, so. It was, I think, some time out with the virtual machine network issue. So comparison result, it has compared all my data and all the rows are matching, which is not very interesting for my demonstration. So I will select some other data so I can save this job. And I will go back to my option, no, overview. I will select this database and this exact same database, in fact. But like you have seen, I can select, for example, my data from two different databases on the same server. Okay. So I click game for this one, game dev for this one. I can go to my option, go back to my mapping because I have changed it. So I refresh it. I have the same table in my two environments. So that's okay. And I can play my job. Normally, we should have some differences, few, but some. So it connects to my source, extracts the data for the first table, does the same for my target, compares the data for these tables, and go on. No. I should probably use an alter for these tables. Let me check here. Or I can edit my data manually, but. Okay. Let's wait just to show you. Okay, so this is DB Artisan. I'm connecting to this one. I go to my database, I go to game, tables. This one edit data. Si ça. Okay. And if I go back, commit it. Yeah. Okay, it is committed. Hop, I go back here. This is yes. If I play again. I should have two differences in my broker table between the two instances. Ah, okay, my bad. I was already having some differences, but this is rounded, and it was 100%. I see I have five rows, so I haven't read nicely. I can click the view button, and from here I will be able to see the differences. I see now I have four differences here with my Jackson and my Nancy. Okay, and we have some other previously existing differences. And we can see them directly from here. Okay, and if I want, I can select one row, for example, and from here I can make source match target for the selected rows, and automatically I say this is the good version I want to keep, and that's it. Jackson will keep this one, and then I will generate the same script, can open it and. It drops the constraint, it changes the name and so on. So this is the data comparison job. And that's it. If I create another one to show you the difference for the data masking, data comparison job, can take this one and this one. Not this one and this one because it doesn't have the second database, this is the one. Okay. So game for this. And I have to show you the different platform support. Also. Options, if I go to the automatic, I have less options for this. But if I go to mapping, if I click refresh current, we can see from here, for example, for the client, I have some the first name and last name. Here, data truncation. Yeah, the size of the data are not the same. One is 60, the other one is 50. So it's warning me that I could lose some data. Okay. And otherwise, I wanted to show you that when we are using the automatic in the option the automatic update, we can select. We have this column which wasn't available in manual, which allow you to randomize and shuffle the data. So shuffle is mixing the data between the rows. And randomize is creating some random values based on the current values included. If it's, for example, numbers, it will only create numbers. If it's some letters, it will create some letters and so on. That's it. And yeah. And like I said, I show you for when we register, we can select these different platforms. Generic JDBC is just useful for the SQL editor. You can use a generic JDBC connection and use some SQL, the SQL editor to run your queries. But you will not be able to use it for the main features, for the archives and comparison jobs. So we are supporting different platforms. And like I said, we can... For example, I can connect to my Oracle the same way as I have connected to my MSQL. And from here, I don't have a node which is databases, but I will find things like my tables directly available here with the schema as a prefix for my source and so on. And I can see my client and things like this. So I should be able, if I go there, from here, I can launch a comparison data job. Okay. You see, I have a right click and click comparison. I have right click and click comparison data comparison job from here. Earlier, I was creating new from this node. You can use file new configuration from this toolbar button. From file new, you have also the same. So many ways to do to achieve what you want to do. Data configuration job I compare Oracle for example with MS SQL. I can do it. I take this. My owner is GIM. My database is also. Synchronize mapping. I can go from here. I refresh my mapping. I will be able to see my table and some different. My Oracle is slower on this VM. This is why I haven't used it earlier in my demo. So it's trying to get my data. And some automatically will. Bind the different data type between the different platforms, numeric with numbers, and other different kind of data type, and some specific fields can be mapped, for example, a blog or some stuff like this. You can't map it directly, so you won't be able to compare this specific columns. Still working. Click here to see my POS data mapping action. I guess say my Oracle. I think this is my driver, which is slower with my connection between my VM, my client. For the different job, I spoke earlier, you have the play button, you can stop it, when it's running. This is where you can click, for example, to generate the command line. Not sure it's a good idea to do it. Yeah, not at the same moment. Should wait. I can do it for. Mm-hmm. Okay, finally. Sorry for that. So it has compared. I can see that I have some partial mapping between my different tables. And if I check here, I can see, for example, that the data hasn't been binded for the timestamp. If I click here, it won't be happy because that 7 and that 10 can't be compared. So I should run a schema comparison before maybe, and to have the same size, and then I will be able to run it properly. So like you see, I'm able to bind. If I go to, for example, in my table client, I have varchar 2 here, varchar here. I have some a number here, a numeric here, and this is my DB change manager, which automatically bind the different data types between the different platforms, and does the job, which is quite powerful. Okay. So that's it, generate command line schedule. I haven't saved it. If I save it, I will be able to generate the command line. The views. Job selection, I can select my job, I can specify the kind of reporting I want to generate, the folder where I want to save the job I want to run, and I can save this script, and automatically will run my DB change manager with the job name, the path, and automatically run it when we schedule it, for example, with the task scheduler, the Windows task scheduler, and we will be able to run it whenever we need. I think we have watched almost all the main features of the product. You can find back the welcome dialog I show you at the beginning. Maybe it will be it will make more sense for you now. What will you like to work with? The setup, so for the data sources, the schema object for to create to configuration an archive jobs or a comparison job. Can directly create my job from here. The job I have work with today and earlier, I can directly reopen them from here. The same for the run, and some tutorials to explain you what you need, what you may want to do, and like I explained earlier, with the cheat sheet which automatically opens from there to here. Okay, that's it. Just reopen my GoToMeeting. Okay. So this is a presentation will be soon ended. This is how to manage the change for the different platforms from the single interface. If you have any question, don't hesitate to contact Aedera directly. You can find our coordinate on our website. You can directly contact your favorite account manager to have some more details, or we can plug a demonstration if you need. You can request a demonstration and we can schedule for more specific data, or if you have some specific question, do not hesitate to contact us. And thank you for attending, and I hope it has been helpful. Cheers. Bye-bye.